Good morning. It's my pleasure to welcome you to our faculty. My name is Benjamin Blankertz, and this pleasure of this welcome comes to me in my role as Dean of Studies that I have here at the faculty for. I would like to, and otherwise, I'm heading the neurotechnology group, and our main research topic is brain-computer interfacing, but that's not the topic here right now. I would like to give a short introduction to our faculty and then quickly pass on to the Freitagsrunde with the main act of how to study. Our faculty consists of two branches, electrical engineering and computer science, and this is where the acronym EECS comes from that you may encounter from time to time, in particular in the addresses of the web pages, for example. At first sight, it might seem a bit surprising to combine these two areas in one faculty. But we think, and also made the experience, this is a particular fruitful combination, and that this interface between electrical engineering and computer science is pivotal for the challenges or some of the big challenges of our times, in particular in application areas like communication, health, mobility, security, and energy. And our orientation towards application is also reflected by the wealth of cooperations that we have with research institutes and industry. And this also gives opportunities for you for internships and master projects and so on. So some numbers about our faculty. We have about 7,500 students, and the ratio of students to professors is 100 to 1. So it's crucial that we are well supported, in particular in teaching, by scientific and technical and administrative staff, and also by about 200 students who work as tutors and help with the lectures, for example. And also a last point that might be of interest to you is that our faculty is particularly strong in company foundings. So if you consider after your master or PhD of founding a spin-off, get informed. There are different ways how the university supports such foundings. There are different important addresses and initiatives that are there to help you. Here I would like to highlight the Freitagsrunde Students Initiative, to whom we are very grateful for organizing this How to Study, and they will give you much more details about these helpful initiatives and pointers. So I would just like to mention the mentoring program, which is organized by our faculty, the mentoring team, and they are there to help you get started into your studies and into student life. They are connection points, say, between you, the students, and the faculty. And their offer is typically very much enjoyed and appreciated by students who take part. So if you don't know it already, I recommend that you check out the webpage, which has a lot of important information all in one point. So with that, I would like to finish and wish you a good start into the study, and hand over to Paul for the main act here. Thank you.
Good morning. Welcome, everyone. My name is Paul. I'm studying computer science in my bachelor's degree, and I will walk you through this presentation, How to Study. For the people on Zoom, we have a Q&A feature and some people in the room who will answer your questions, and please ask a question via the Q&A feature and not in the chat. It's easier for us. Okay, and one question before I start for the people in the room. For who has his first semester at the TU Berlin right now, his first master semester, raise your hand. Okay, almost all of you. Okay, perfect. You are the target audience. And where to find these slides? I will upload them to freitagsrunde.org and later on the other websites too. I am the backup speaker for this talk and got the call for the backup last Friday, so I'm a little bit unprepared at some parts, but we will work through it. So you don't have to take notes, but you can find the slides later. Okay. Next thing before we start, if something remains unclear, you have still questions, you want like a one-to-one help setting, the Student Advisory Service at our university or Faculty 4 has this week every day office hours and the upcoming weeks also. So if something remains unclear, ask or join the Matrix server of TU Berlin and ask where the Freitagsrunde or visit us in our room in the March building in room 005. Okay, with that, the talk is structured into three parts. We have an introduction part, an overview about the most important systems at the university. Then I have a live presentation. I will enroll into one course and show you the different systems and how they work. And after that, the third part is tips and tricks about studying at TU Berlin. This slide is the most important slide, I think, for you in the next week. You need to understand that the university thought it would be a good idea to have multiple teaching platforms. You need all of them, and they're all a little bit different and do something else, but you need to understand in the upcoming week that what each platform is doing and where and why to use it. And we will go about all of them in greater detail in the second part of this talk. Yeah, just keep in mind the most important thing for you this week is understanding and using these three platforms and working through it. The next thing is the university also thought it would be a good idea to have multiple auger systems. So we will also go over them and talk through them in the second part of the talk. And each year the university has a bigger problem. Last year it was COVID-19 and the year before it was a TU hack. And this year the problem the university and you are struggling with is a web relaunch. So some months ago the university updated the server backend and or frontend, I'm not sure exactly, but in the process of doing that, a lot of the English websites got lost and some of the institutes or chairs also. So if you can't find something, it's maybe because of the web relaunch. You can use the German site. They have usually more information and you can use sometimes the web archives if you're really desperate to find something. But I will show you in the second part to be aware that we have two systems at the moment, the old website and the new website with a new design. And if you know where to look for, you can see if you're on an old website with old information or on a new website with new information and you want to be on the new website with new and information. Okay. Other thing, question for the room, which of you is already enrolled into the degree program? Raise your hand. One, two, not so much than the first question. Okay, so the university struggled really hard this year to enroll all persons on time. All the things I will show you in the second part of the presentation will also work with your applicant account or your Bewerber account. You use the same ID and the usual password to enroll into ISIS courses or use MOSIS. And if something doesn't work at all, you can ask the Student Advisory Service or ask the Freitagsrunde or ask the technical support, and we will figure something out. Okay. I talked about how you need to understand ISIS and MOSIS, the like teaching platforms, but the important part is at our university, you don't have to enroll into, as you enroll into a course or a module, but you don't need to register for it. So you have, you can, or other way, you need to register for exams, but not for the courses and informations. It's to register for a course via ISIS is like subscribing to a YouTube channel. It doesn't really have, like, doesn't do anything other than you get information. Okay. The university is like a government agency, and all the things are regulated and written down somewhere. And for you, there are two important rule sets you need to follow. The first one is your study examination regulations or Studien- und Prüfungsordnung. And we have for each master degree program its own study regulations. We will go to the work through one of these study regulations, and you have to read your study regulation in this week now and understand what the university wants from you. And if you think it's too much text, it's like 4 or 5 pages long, but start with section 5, organization of your studies, and work from there. The other thing is the university has for all degree programs a general study regulation guide. And I would advise to walk through the table of contents, and after that, if you're new here, walk to section 47, the course formats, and section 55, the portfolio examination, because it's maybe a new examination form for you, so you get a better understanding what you need to do. Okay, and after that, if you're only English speaking, the university has a glossary, so you can work through some of the technical terms, and some of the translations are not really clear, so you can use that to get a better understanding, yeah, what means what. Okay, and with that, I will translate into the second part, navigating through one example hybrid semester. The slide is a little bit from last year with COVID-19, but this year we have also, well, there is the possibility that you're also experiencing a hybrid semester because the university doesn't have enough rooms to fit all students. We are missing some buildings like the math building and chemistry and physics buildings, and we simply don't have enough rooms to fit all the modules. So you might encounter a module which just doesn't got a room, and you have like a Zoom online seminar, for example. I'm not sure, it might happen, it's just a heads up. My example walkthrough through the semester follows this flowchart right here, and essentially there are some critical points. One is the start of the semester. This is the one we will talk right now, how and where to choose your modules. And then other critical parts is end of lecture period with your registration of your exams, and after the lecture period, and then the end of the semester. And we will walk through to all the critical steps of this flowchart in the next 20, 30 minutes. if you want to look this flowchart up again, you can look it up at universityabc or uniabc.freitagsrunde.org and scroll down to the bottom, and there you can look at this flowchart again. Okay. Before we start with how to find the modules and how to use MOSES and ISIS, you have a mail account which might work with your applicant ID or not, but as soon as you are enrolled and have your TU mail, you have to log on to your mails. The university does all the important information the university will send to you via mail. And if you start studying here, you're signing a paper that you read the general study regulation, and then in this general study regulations, there's a paragraph 42, which enforces that you do read your mails. So you have to apply to this rule and read your mails every second day. It's like a good rule of thumb. And also, if you miss something and because you didn't read your mails, it's not an excuse. So the idea being, read your mails, and university communicates via mail a lot of the times. University also tends to spam you with mails if you are not carefully. So we will go in ISIS, you can find some settings to reduce the spam so you can get less mails and only the important mails. One slide for a little bit of advertisement. The university is hosting its own Matrix server instant on the TU servers, and it's an open source free messenger service where the Freitagsrunde is very active, and like it's a recommendation from my side and from the Freitagsrunde to use it a bit, and the university is trying to push it a little bit, and yeah, it can be helpful to stay in touch in the first week, but you can also use your own messenger services. Okay, now I'm hoping that I don't crash with my screen share. One second. Can everybody in the room and at Zoom see like a blank Firefox slide? I mean, okay, perfect. And I will do that and do that. Okay. For my example run-through, I will enroll, or I'm enrolled in the Master Computer Science, and I want to choose my first module. And therefore, I will start visiting TU.Berlin to find my study regulations, so I do know which rules to follow and which not. And I go to the submenu, and I show the long way right now. The important part is to find the study regulations. Give me one second. So I go to faculties, and first I change language to English. Okay. I go to faculty 4, EECS. And first thing, now, do you see? At the moment, I don't have a submenu up here. If I go a little bit out with my zoom, a submenu appears, and this is a known bug. So please be careful, so because I just want to show it that way. We have academics and teaching here. I want my master programs, and I have now a list of all the master programs at faculty 4. I'm choosing computer science, a little bit of zoom out, and I will zoom in at one second, just a visual, take a look at the visuals right here, because I want to demonstrate another thing. If you would just choose or search for computer science, we have a main website, you have a search bar here, and I'm searching for computer science. When we have like computer science informatic master degree program right here, and the website looks different, not a lot of CSS files and not so good designed like the other file. So if I'm going here, same picture at the top, but not this CSS file and not these submenus. And that's because this is the old design and the old website, which is still somewhere on the site, and there are not all information present. Okay, so I would advise going here and scrolling down to find your study and examination regulations and searching for the reading version or the Lesefassung in German, because you don't want the normal study regulations, because you have to do a lot of backtracking in there. Okay, I'm opening my study regulations, lot of text, and I'm going to section 5, organization of studies. And like the first three rules are, it's not so important, like in detail, just I follow the first three rules and I see that I have, your university has like a flowchart for you, and the rules are in section 5, and the flowchart here is saying I have one compulsive elective area and 5 other areas in this case where I have to choose from. So I have to choose in the master computer science one main area I want to focus on. And okay, and they are so nice and also giving me a list of modules I can choose from. So I have my study regulation, I worked through the section 5 and the appendix at this point, and now I'm visiting MOSES and the module transfer system on MOSES to find my modules I can choose. I'm going via this link. So I'm right now on MOSES, on the module transfer system, at the Computer Science Master of Science degree program, and there are no modules here, and that's because you have to choose out of the module list, it doesn't choose for you, and I want to choose the newest one, and the website is reloading, and now I can change it to English. I have like the different, a table with the different modules I can choose from, and the translation doesn't really work. Even though I'm changing to English, there are still Studiengebiete and stuff. So I can't change this, but I know the compulsory elective areas is the German, the English word for Studiengebiete. I click on that and have the six areas which are also mentioned in the study regulations. If I click on the first one just for demonstration, it looks like nothing happened, but the table opens up down there. So okay, for my presentation, I want to have my main focus on cognitive systems. Again, clicking on where nothing happened, but it's opened up down there. And down here, how to use the module, this module transfer system is you have now all modules listed which are which the faculty like presents to you, and you have the overview of the most important information. You have the name and not so important, the version and the module number, but how many credit points you can get, if it's graded or not, the type of exam, we will talk in greater detail about that, the language and the frequency it's will be taught. So you noticed a lot of times the frequency is missing, and that's also a known bug. You have to click on the module, and in the detailed module description you can find it, but it's not listed here. And okay, I'm not sure, yesterday I want machine learning one. It's an English and written exam with 9 ECTS credit points. So I click on that, and now I'm on the module description of one module in MOSES, and I'm greeted with like the name of the module, the responsible person, the same information I just saw, but also contact information if something remains unclear after I'm working through this Moses part. And so I can look up learning outcomes and content, and I can look up the module components. We will also talk about different types of what you of like modules, or what modules can, how can I say it? So the university has different types of courses, and this one is an integrated lecture, and we will talk about this in greater detail, or you can read it up in the study regulations. So if something remains unclear, you can backtrack all the acronyms. Yeah, I wanted to show this because I didn't really understand the workload and credit points of this particular module, because it says right here you have to do 6 weeks, 6 hours a week for this module to get like, or you have the workload of this module is 6 hours a week, but down here we are listing wrong amount of hours. And the first thing you can do about that is to check out which rooms the module has blocked for themselves. You have a magnifying glass right here, and VZ is German word for Verzeichnis and means the room indexing system. So if I click on that, I have a study plan, and I can see that machine learning one has one exercise on Monday and one lecture on Thursday. And so I have now more information where this lecture and the exercise started. I also have a room number. And you notice right now, hopefully, that's a little bit complicated to get the information. And for your choosing of your courses, you will work through these steps for each course. So, yeah. So now I know which module. I know I want to take this module. I know in which rooms the module takes place. And now I need more information about this module, maybe some. So I now will use ESIS. And the information system for instructor and students, and also searching there for the same module. First things first, okay, I'm searching for the module, and I'm just copying machine learning one into the search. And it doesn't show up at the first entry or the second down here. And that's because the ESIS search is fundamentally broken. It's like a fuzzy search that doesn't really work. It's never the first thing you are looking for. It's always down there. So, okay, machine learning one way to work around this is to go to courses, all courses, and say, okay, I know because of Moses, it's a faculty 4 module. I can see it right here. So I can say, okay, I want a course from faculty 4. I expand all and control F. Machine learning is faster than searching via fuzzy search. Okay, I have machine learning 1 found right here. And now it's asking me to log in. And you can use your TU login or your Bewerber account, or you can log in as guest sometimes. If nothing works, I can go back to Moses and ask the responsible person, like, what I have to do to go into this course. And I will choose the TU login and log in with my account. And okay, he is asking to enroll. Again, no really valid translation here. And maybe because I'm, so, okay. And now I'm at ESIS enrolled into the course, and I have the same information I found at Moses with the rooms. Monday there is an exercise and Thursday there is a lecture. I have a room number, I have a language and credits, and I have, okay, we didn't really do a lot of this course, but we have some information papers, we have a matrix cookbook, a PDF about some information before the module starts. And that's the way I can use Moses and Isis to choose my modules and work through it. And I hope you notice there's a lot of work and a lot of backtracking and searching. And therefore, you need to use this week to use the time to get things figured out. And yeah, some questions up until now from your side. Yeah, please. The question for the Zoom audience is, some courses require a key. Where can I find this key? It depends. Sometimes you will get the key on the first lecture. And so the professor wants you to show up there and they will talk you through to get this key. Other times, Moses is linking a website from the responsible persons, and you can work through that. We're linking to an old wiki, and we're linking on this old wiki to their website, and over there you can find we are teaching course offerings and stuff. You could find it sometimes there, and sometimes you can ask the responsible person via Moses. So if machine learning one had the code and you don't find it anywhere, you can write at this mail address via contact and ask them there, what is the key. Usually they use this feature because they have a limitation of how many people can enroll into this course. And each department is working with us differently. So there is no general answer to that, but use the contact information and search through the links. And you may find it, you may find it not. I have a problem seven semesters in a row with this course problem. Just ask a lot of people and you will find it eventually. Okay, other questions until now? And the main concept is clear. You look in your study regulation, you look up what modules you have to choose, and I chose computer science and I can choose relatively freely. And after that, you search the module up on Moses, you search for which room it's in, you search for contact information, you search the ISIS course, and then you work out how to generate your study plan. Okay, question, yeah, please. Is the next thing we will talk about. The question was, there's sometimes a question on the ISIS course, please register to tutorials via Moses. And yeah, I can show you that also. For this feature, you have to log in Moses. You have a login right here, and you can use your TU account or your Bewerber account, your applicant account. You go to login, and now I'm logged in, and you have more submenus down here, and you have even though I'm English, it's again the German word tutorial planning, tutorials or planning of tutorials, and you can over there schedule and register for a tutorial, and you just typing in the name of the module, and after you hit enter, you are registered for the module you want to choose. Is this clear? So Moses has an extra tab for tutorial registration. Okay. I think that's all I want to show with Isis and Moses. It takes some time to get used to it. Use this week to get familiar with it. Okay. Ah, okay, one last thing. The search feature on Moses has not all the options you might need. You can't filter for seminars or project. Therefore, some students are crawling each semester all Moses courses and applying their own search filters for it. So you can, if I have to have a project in the computer science master, for example, and this feature head here to search or filter for projects is not present on the Moses, in the Moses search. So you, I linked the slide or the link to this website on the slides. We have our own websites run by students, so you can easier find your modules or your projects in some seminars, but it's also run by students, so no guarantees, but usually we are better than the Moses search and have more information. Okay, here again, the link. And now I'm trying to get my screen share back to working. Okay. Machine learning one was a written exam. Machine learning one was an integrated course. We have also different course types at our university. The usual lecture exercises, which also sometimes are called grade exercise or Großübung, but mean the same thing. Tutorials, labs, projects, seminars, and the integrated course is like a mix of all of you above. So you noticed that Machine Learning 1 has a lecture and an exercise and some programming. So we, like this mix of courses is combined into an integrated course, and you have to read through the module description to find out which parts make up the course. Some courses require a registration. That's because we have not enough room to fit all the people we want to apply to this course, and that's usually done via ESIS, via a key you have to put in, and they have sometimes extra tools to give out the keys, or the keys were given at the first lecture. For all courses, there is never an option to register for the course via Moses, only for tutorials. There are some features where you can click on Moses to add to your study plan. Like, they are really hidden, and I didn't want to show you because this feature doesn't do anything for you other than putting it in a calendar you will have a hard time finding. So course registration is always done via ESIS and sometimes with an extra tool, an extra website, because there's the key or like the scheduling algorithm is running on an extra website. Okay. After that, you will translate into the lecture period, and there's not much to say, I guess. You all studied already. Oh yeah, a question. For tutorials or? Okay. So the question is, if I register via ISIS, are there more information about tutorials and exercises and lectures on ISIS directly? And usually, yes. We have like a bigger description at the start of the ISIS course and give you all the information you need what to do on the other platforms. And if something remains unclear, you can ask via ISIS or via mail or ask Student Advisory Service. Okay? Okay. We have multiple the university has multiple options to have students work in groups, and via tutorials there is an option to register a group in Moses so you and your partners can join the same tutorial if you have to visit a tutorial. And then there are homework groups for prerequisites. A lot of modules like Machine Learning 1 is also doing that, has like a homework prerequisite, and you have to fulfill this prerequisite to even to be allowed to write the exam. And all these things are like no surprises. In Moses, they are listed all the prerequisites and what exam the course will be. So you can know ahead of time, do I need to do homeworks, or do I need to do programming, or which type of exam will it be? And therefore, yeah, no surprises there. And some like general points, you can notify the scientific staff and the professor if your group doesn't work, and you should notify them early, and you notify your fellow group members if you can't finish your task. It's a slide from the bachelor presentation. I think you already know like the usual workings with groups. Okay, next thing, the lecture period comes to an end, and the university has three exam types. We have a written exam and the oral exam, and which are pretty self-explanatory, I guess. And we have the portfolio examination. And portfolio means that you have a lot of little tests and homeworks which are graded throughout the semester, and usually up to 100 points. And you accumulate points throughout the semester. You have a homework here and a presentation there, like a programming task. And at the end of the semester, it's all summed up for your grade. The problem with portfolio examination is that you have to register before the first assignment, the first homework is given out. So the idea being you don't know what the task will be. And the problem is after the first task is given to you, you can't deregister from this course. So other than with oral and written exams, you can deregister up until 3 days before the written exam or the oral exam will take place. But with portfolio exams, after you have your first like task, you can't deregister from this course anymore. And a lot of courses, modules are portfolio exams. So if you're choosing 5 portfolio exams this semester, and you notice it's too much for you, then you can't deregister if you already handed in some work. And this might become a problem later into the semester. So be aware of that. The problem with portfolio examination is that you can't deregister after your first assignment. Exam registration also works via Moses. For the people who are speaking German, we have the module transfer system, and directly to the right of the set menu, we have Klausuren, and now it's called Klausurterminplanung. You never register for exams via the Klausuren part. You always go over module transfer system and then module examinations register, and where you can register for exams, which will always be explained in the ISIS course. So I have a slide here, and the moment you have to register for a course, the scientific staff will explain you on the ISIS course what to do, but you have to register on Moses for that. You have like a flow chart, because usually you have to register via module transfer system and Modulprüfung, because it really doesn't translate well here again. And we have one exclusive OR right here in the middle. And if it doesn't work for some reason, because the university gets hacked again for, I don't know, but we have also what's called a yellow sheet, and which is a PDF document, which is not yellow anymore, but it used to be like two papers back to back. One was yellow, where comes the name yellow sheet form, and you can register via paper. And if for some reason you can't register via MTS and via MOSES, you can follow through this flowchart and work things out and work the registration out via yellow sheet. And if this doesn't work, again, ask questions, ask the module, the responsible person of the module. It's important information is we have a second way to register for exams, as the first way doesn't work. Okay, so we chosen our modules, we registered for an exam via MOSES or via yellow sheet, and now the lecture ends and we will write our exam, for example. And if we don't feel like we learned enough, we have the option to deregister up until 3 days before the examination. How long an exam can be, how long a portfolio examination can be, and how long an oral examination can be is all written down in the general study regulation. So no professor can say like, okay, I want to test you for 10 hours now. We have a rule set, which you can find in the general study regulations. The Freitagsrunde is collecting a lot of exams, and you can help us with that. So after you written your exam, you can take some notes and send them to the Klausurensammlung of the Freitagsrunde. I looked up yesterday just for fun. Machine Learning One has also like 7 or 8 old examinations and like notes and what questions were asked and screenshots and stuff. So it's a good resource, and we are trying to have as many exams present as possible. So if you want to get an idea, also if you're choosing your courses, which what will the examination look like, you can look at the Klausurensammlung der Freitagsrunde. Other thing is, I want to write the exam, I get sick, you have the option to hand in the sick note 5 days, up until 5 days after the examination. We have an office who can walk you through the process, the examination office, if something remains unclear. So if you are sick and you're not really feeling, okay, am I doing everything right? You can ask the examination office and they will help you and guide you through the process. But the important thing is you can hand in your sick notes 5 days after the examination, up until 5 days after the exam. After the exam, we have usually an inspection, or you have the option to inspect your exam. Usually it's a good idea to go there, and you can also send somebody else if you don't have the time. And your grade can't get worse, only can get better, so I would use this option every time. When we have, like, usually the points you get in your exam or via your portfolio proof will convert it into grades, and we have like 3 different grade systems, one with which gets your A plus at 59, 95 out of 100 points, one of 90 from 100 points, and one of 85. So we have 3 different keys to grade you, and you always can look up the key, which is the module using, on the MOSES website. Usually you have 2 time frames where you can take your exam, the first 3 weeks after the lecture period and the last 3 weeks before the next semester starts. So this year or this week, a lot of people are writing exams like this week right now, because we don't have enough rooms and we have to push back the exam a little bit, but you have two times where you can write your exams to, and you can choose which one you want. If you fail an exam, you have three repetitions or three times you can repeat your exam. The last one is always oval. With this semester starting, we have a fourth attempt after you have a meeting with a student advisory service. So I wouldn't go into the fourth attempt, but for you to know, you have three attempts, and all compulsory elective modules and elective modules can be replaced. So if you failed a module one or two times and don't want to go into a third try, you can ask the examination office before you choose another module that you want to replace that module. And then you can choose another module and don't have to access the third examination. And I would visit the student advisory service, ask them again about what your options are. But the important thing is you can replace your failed examinations, and maybe you should use it. I was talking about different organization systems. We have KISPOS, the first one. It's an old system. It's just there to give you your transcript of records, and it will generate a PDF file for you. Then grades are written manually into your transcript of records. So check from time to time if everything is right in your transcript of records. And the system, I don't know this is because it's old, but the system has like opening hours. So this website closes down from 10 in the afternoon to 8 in the morning. You can't use this website. I was trying to figure out why this is. For 8 hours, I'm not sure. Okay, backups. Okay, I'm not sure. Okay, the important part is it closes down for the night. So, yeah. Okay, last few things. You have to re-register each semester, and the university asks for some money and sometimes some notes from some other details, some other documents. And usually the last Saturday of the lecture period is the time you can re-register without the penalty fee. And with a penalty fee, about 20 euros, you have the last day until the next semester starts. And you re-register via Tuport, the next organization systems, where you can find the tab re-registration, and will explain you what is missing and what's not. And also via Tuport, you can all get all the important documents. Now it's showing a video. You will find like a tab of okay, important documents and certificates, and you will click on one and you can get an error. And if you click it again, you will get the document after some time. The problem is it's a LaTeX document and it's never cached, so it's re-regenerated every time, and the server is slower than the website. So click two times on your certificates and you will get it, and it's a known bug. So, okay. And then like it starts all again. You choose out your modules, you search for Moses and Isis courses, you register for your tutorials, you look up your transcript of records on KISPOS, you re-register via Tuport, and yeah. I have some tips and tricks for you, like 4 slides, 5 slides, and then I'm finished. The university has the academic quota. It's more for bachelor degree students, but so most of the lectures, all of the lectures usually start CT with time, but exams start starting ST on time so don't be late. Thesis topic, some, it's a little bit difficult sometimes. We have a lot of students and not enough institutes, chairs, professors to have enough thesis like on time for all of you in some degree programs. And so if you're choosing your courses, think about in which direction you want to go and where you want to write your thesis. So because some of the professors want that you have heard one, two or three modules at their chair. And yeah, if you are like studied 4 or 5 semesters and didn't really thought about it, it may be difficult to get a thesis. One other thing, the university has a compensation for disadvantages or Nachteilsausgleich. If you have something that like needs to be compensated because you need more time to write an exam or something else, some possible things are listed on the slide. We have a like a process for that. You can get help with your exams. Most of the slides I'm showing and the features I explained are also explained in our Uni ABC, which is in English and in German, and you can find it on if you search for Uni ABC at Google or via freitagsrunde.org, and then something remains unclear. Yeah, you can find it here. We have also a printed version, but only in German, and it's right out the door. And it might be helpful. So the flowchart I showed you at the beginning through the semester is also printed there. You can use it. We have a little bit of a checklist at the of a checklist you can work with through too. And with that, I want to advertise some things which are coming up this week. Right after this talk here, we have a campus tour for master students. So I guess this person right here will like walk you through the campus and show you like the important points. We have the degree specific introductions tomorrow and on Wednesday. And we have Studieren ist mehr, or like we want to show the campus life on Friday. And if you want to find more upcoming events, you can search for mentoring at TU Berlin, and we have linked a Padlet with all the different things you can do this week or the next week, the social things to get to know people. And with that, I welcome you to Faculty 4. I hope you enjoy your time here. I'm sorry I was not as prepared as I wished. So, and yeah, have a good time. Use this week to understand Isis and Moses. I know it's hard, but you can do it. Yeah, and with that, if any questions, you can ask them, and I'm finished with my talk. Thank you very much.